It's me.
We want to go back to the police officer's area, see if he's got anything new, you know? So we dumped it. We haven't organized it, but we're already on the way, so let's talk to old Hooters.
Hooters, this is a children's game. There's no Hooters in a children's game.
What time is it?
I'm so very sleepy. Oh dear me, 1,000 pardons, so terribly sorry. I'm afraid I'm a bit of a night, owl, yes. Yes, well, by the by, might there be something in which I can assist you?
Just taking a sippy sippy of my water. Splendid, what no doubt priceless item have you for us today? Have you ever heard of mammoth torso?
Who I say,
a mammoth torso. The day the remaining pieces of our prehistoric puzzle are found will be a joyous one indeed. Good luck to you. I say good luck, sir. You have our deepest, most profound gratitude. Might there be anything else you wish to donate?
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, Daddy. Blathers is our daddy. Don't. That's not true. He's our granddaddy.
A stego torso.
You got anything else to say? You're not going to comment that I just brought you the largest mammal on Earth? The mammoth? Is it? Was it the largest recorded mammal? Is the mammoth?
Where do you think mammal came from? Mammal? Mammoth?
That's not true. Looks like some paleontology is afoot.
Paleontology is afoot!
Three-toed foot tells us this is the print of a theropod form from perhaps the Jurassic period. It's impossible to discern anything more specific, but the speculation is free and a vital part of paleontology. Imagine a terrible carnivore stalking its prey. Its great weight pressing down into the earth and voila, history. Aren't I the blatherer?
Well, your name is Blathers.
Don't put me into a comatose state. You have the deepest, most profound gratitude. No, sir. So,
well, for Kaija, you just gave away all these cool fossils. Now what?
Well, thanks for asking. Well, he just went to sleep right away. Look, check it out. It's the dinosaur track. And it's... hold on. How is that? It's just floating. This little dingle. Anyways, this is the mammoth torso. And bada bing, bada boom, we got ourselves a stegosaurus body. And if you take a look, is this it? This is all the fossils in the game? That's actually not too bad. We can accomplish this. Later on, there's different rooms. There's a lot of different stuff. This is the hardest one to complete. I think I've only turned in like one or two in my main game, but you get these paintings from a man called Red. What time is it? Nothing. There's also fish and bugs. So we got our work cut out for you if you're a min-maxer completionist type. I'd love to complete this game. Check it out, I dug up a fossil. Bada bing, bada boom, you already know what that's. What we do with that. Write letter. Fossil. Fossil space. Oh, we have multiple fossils. Oh my lord, what happened? We got a lot of writing to do. Stop making that same mistake. Yes. Absolutely. They think my IQ is, like, 1, but my ability to find fossils is, like, 100. Wow. Zers? And bada bing, bada boom, we are, look at us. We have cleaned up our inventory quite some. Festive tree. Oh, baby. We gotta head back into the old, what are we calling our house? The Love Shack.
Love Shack, baby. Love Shack, yeah.
on. Post office. We'll talk to... Is this the nice lady? Yes, it is.
Good day. How can I help you?
Mail a letter. Bada bing, bada boom. Oh, there's a mail in the background. Ah, yes, I see. Would you like to mail more letters? Yes, please. I have multiple letters to send to the museum. Because they are the only people I talk to. The only people that aren't freaking rude to me. Yes. This one's extra special. This is the Wowzers one. No, thank you. Look at that. We are making so much... Last time, we actually made more progress last time in the middle of the night, probably, than we did this time. But the difference is we're making a different kind of progress. See, this, if we were playing Survivor last episodes, that was the strategic game. You know, we did the fastest way to make money and we turned it in, and now Tom Nook is happy. But this is the social game. We're going around and we're talking to people, we're getting deeds done. Dirty deeds done dirt cheap, you know what I'm saying? Oh, it's the... I know you! Hold on. Excuse me. A mega gyroid. So, this girl's very complicated, especially for a child's game. She sells you turnips based on the economic satisfaction of the town or something.
Well, hello there, kiddo. It's Sunday morning, and I've been selling my turnip for about 60 years. So, Joanne, the name you can trust. So, Joanne, do you need me to explain how turnip training works?
Well, this will explain it.
Well, first things first.
Sure, these turnips are edible, but no one buys them for eating anymore. Nowadays, folks buy and sell turnips to make money. Do you want to hear more? Absolutely. You know Tom Nook, right? Well, you can sell your turnip stocks to him. Old Tom's always keeping his eyes on the stock market. Get it? The stock market. The prices change every day. You can earn some extra money if you sell your turnips at a higher price than you paid for them. Of course, it goes without saying that you'll lose money if you sell for less than you paid. But I'm sure you didn't need me to tell you that. Still want to know more? Absolutely. Hit me with it. Here's the most important thing you need to remember. The turnips go bad after 1 week. The stocks wilt, and no one wants to buy a turnip with a wilted stock. You'll find me out here selling turnips every Sunday. If you haven't sold the turnips you bought before Tom's store closes Saturday night, you'll lose all the money you spent buying turnips. So watch out. It's better to sell your turnips before they go bad, even if the price is much lower than you paid. Sometimes you just have to eat your losses. Don't eat the food. Don't eat the turnips. At least you won't lose everything. And there is one thing you can do if you get desperate. Turnip prices vary from village to village. That means if you go to another village, well, just remember, timing is everything when you're selling turnips. Want to know more? What you got? One more thing. The turnips come in bunches of 10, 50, and 100. You can't buy or sell turnips individually, just in bunches. For instance, if you buy a bunch of 50 turnips, you can't just sell 10 of those. You'll have to sell all 50. See what I mean? In that case, what you want to do is buy 5 bunches of 10 turnips. That's just about all I have to say about turnips. Maybe that was too much for you to take in all at once. Would you like to hear my explanation again? No, thank you. Phew. I was going to whack you with a turnip if you asked me to go through all that again. Today's ask price is 93 bells. I feel like that's kind of expensive. Let's see, 930? We can probably buy 2 bunches of 10. 930. Very easy. Here you go, kiddo. So we gotta keep our eye on the stock market. Yes, let me buy more. I think I had like 2,000 something. If I have 2,000, over 2,700, I could buy another one. Just 10 turnips? That'll run you 930 bells. Oh, we do have enough money. Okay. This is how you make that cashola, baby. You make that fat stacks. We're in there. This is the Wall Street. Can I even buy more? Oh, we don't have enough. Okay. You're all out of money, kiddo. Thanks anyway. Come back again. Check it out, boys. We got plenty of turnips. And remember, the selling price was 93. So we want to hit above 93. We don't have any lost items. Please don't be too mad at me. All right, get out of here, Booker. We don't have time.
Thank you for stopping by. Please come again to pick up some stolen goods.
That's what he sounds like now.
That's it.